Hello everyone, my name is Matt, and today I'll be providing a more in-depth look at how to use the planning and design platform from USAN 811. This video will guide you through using the platform to request information during your project's design phase. Projects often need detailed planning, and obtaining underground utility information during the design phase can be challenging. An 811 ticket is only issued for scheduled excavation within a specific time frame. The planning and design platform helps by providing contact information for utility owners when your work is scheduled to begin beyond the legally required start time. In California, an 811 ticket can be submitted 14 days before excavation, and in Nevada, 28 days before. For projects scheduled beyond these periods, you can use the planning and design platform to gather necessary utility information. With that said, the planning and design process does not replace the legally required 811 ticket. When your excavation work is scheduled to begin within the legally allotted timeframe, you will be required to submit an 811 ticket before work can begin, even if you have received utility information during the design phase of your project. It's important to know that the planning and design platform is state-specific. If you are requesting utility information in California, you will need to use the California version of the platform, and vice versa for requests in Nevada. You can easily verify which state's program you are using by looking at the title at the top of the login screen. If you do not have an account with the planning and design platform, click on the Sign Up Here link on the bottom of the page. Follow the prompts to register for the platform. When entering your company name, you may notice an autofill feature or drop-down menu appear. Please make sure to select your company from the list provided. If you do not see your company name in the list, select Not Listed, and then type in your company name manually in the box below. For job position, please select the role that most closely aligns with your current position. Follow the remaining prompts to create your account. Afterwards, you will receive an email where you will need to confirm your information before gaining access to the platform. If you ever forget your username or password, you can request that information or reset it by clicking these links. After logging in, you will see the dashboard. The planning and design platform looks similar to the one-call access ticket entry platform. To help distinguish between the two platforms, we changed the header to the color blue and included the planning and design title at the top. Also note that the state is included in that title. It's important to verify that you are using the correct platform before submitting requests, since this platform is only for requesting utility information for design purposes. On the dashboard will be your stats that will show a brief breakdown of the amount of requests you submit. You will also be able to see a graph of how many requests you submit in a month. Below that will be your recent history, which will display the 5 most recent requests you have created. To access your user profile, click on this icon on the top right-hand corner. Here, you can view and edit the information on your profile, including your password. After making any edits in the system, please make sure to click the Save icon to save those changes. Next to the User Profile button is a gear icon. Clicking this gear icon will open the default request settings menu. Here, you will be able to create presets on your requests that will be automatically selected when starting a new request. You can change these options and save them anytime by clicking the Save icon above. Let's close this side menu now and look at the left-hand menu options. The dashboard is currently what we're seeing on our screen. Under New Request, we will see Message of the Day and Service Announcements. Clicking these buttons will display important information as determined by our staff. If we click in the History section, we will be able to look at all of our previous requests. Remember that these requests will be specific to you and your account. We have options on how to sort and filter the requests for easier viewing. We can also search for a specific request number or a city that the request was submitted in. We can also narrow the date range of when the request was submitted, or we can clear the date ranges by clicking the X next to each date. If we click on a request, we will be able to see the request details, the project site polygon, and the utility member's contact information included on the request. To create a new request, click on the Home menu button. Then click either New Request on the left-hand menu or on the top right-hand corner of the window. If you chose to assign user presets to your account, the information will automatically be carried over into the corresponding fields when submitting your request. If you did not assign any user presets in the User Settings menu, then each field will be left blank and will need to be filled out manually. For type of work, please select the option that best describes the work that will take place at the project site. Then select the date and time you would like to receive a response in this menu. When selecting a target response date, please keep in mind that there is currently no legal requirement for utility operators to respond to a planning and design request. This information will be sent to participating members who elect to receive planning and design notifications from our center. Once the request has been submitted, you should contact each utility operator directly to request information about their subsurface installations at your project site. Then select the anticipated construction start date. You can also add a project or work order number in this field. You will also need to indicate whether your projected workplace will be in the roadway, on private property, or both. If work is taking place in the roadway, please select if it is on the shoulder, sidewalk, or road right-of-way, then click Next. Now we will be required to look up the location and highlight the project area on the map. You can choose to look up a location by an address, intersection, or GPS coordinates, which is listed as X, Y. If you plan on using GPS coordinates to pull up the location on the map, make sure that your GPS coordinates are in the decimal format, also known as NAD83. The map is integrated with Google Maps and will also allow you to search for landmarks, businesses, parks, or other non-address specific locations. Just type in the location as you would when using Google Maps. I'll search our office as an example. This information is only being used to pull up an area on the map and will not be included on the request. The map will zoom into our office and have a blue crosshair icon over the area. To zoom in and out of the map, you can click the plus or minus button here, or drag the bar up or down. You can also use the scroll wheel on your mouse. To pan across the map, left-click and hold to drag the map in a specific direction. If you would like to measure a distance without highlighting an area on the map, you can click on the ruler icon. You can then click on the map and drag your mouse to begin your measurement. The ruler tool will show the measurement in feet and miles and will also have the bearing that you're heading in. You can double-click or press the escape button to end the measurement. Underneath the ruler tool is the pin tool. Using this tool will allow you to place pins on the map for reference. This becomes useful when measuring multiple points on the map. You can also change the map from satellite view to street view in the map layers menu. In this same menu, you will be able to toggle specific layers that may help you when mapping out your location. One of those layers is the parcel layer. This will show you the listed address, if known, for a specific area on the map. Take a moment to look over the additional layers available to you. Once you find the area on the map where you would like to receive utility information, you will want to select the mapping tools and draw out your project area. It's important to completely cover your project area, as that will determine which utility operators are included on your request. If the wrong area is highlighted, some utility operators may not be included on your planning and design request. If your project is at a single point, you can use the circle tool to draw a circle around that area. Just click, hold, and drag your cursor to change the size of the circle. You will also see the measurements of the circle on the map. The measurements will include the diameter and radius of the circle as it's drawn. Once you let go of the mouse, the area will be highlighted. This red area will represent your project area on the map. Clicking the polygon tool will allow you to add points along the path or area of your project site. This tool allows you to precisely highlight your project site on the map. Just start clicking on the map to add points. As you add points, you will see a measurement that measures from your last point to the location of your mouse. You will also see the square footage of the area that is being drawn. To complete your polygon, click back to your original starting point on the map. This will close out the custom shape that you have made. Once you have closed your mapping by clicking on your original point, the polygon will be set in place. If you ever make a mistake, you can click on the Delete tool to remove the layers and start over. You also have the ability to edit your mapping. Click the Edit button, and then click and hold a white point on your mapping to move it or change the size of the polygon. After you have completely highlighted the limits of your project area, click Next. The system will now need you to confirm the location of the area. In some cases, the system may try to change the address based on the area that you highlighted. If this happens, the system will display a pop-up message asking you to select which address you would like to use. You can use the address you originally searched for, the address that the system is suggesting based on your project area mapping, or change the information completely. The information that you enter in these fields will be included on the request as part of the project area. So if you are at an address, you will want to list it here as well as the closest intersecting street. If you are not at an address, you will want to include the intersection that you are measuring your distances from. Click Next once completed. In the project description notes, you will need to provide a description of where your project is located. In this case, since I am at an address, I will need to describe where on the property the project will be, such as front of, back of, left or right side when facing, north, south, east, west, etc. If your project is not at an address, you will need to provide distances and directions from an intersection to the starting point of your project area, and then describe the area with distances and directions from that starting point. You'll then need to read and confirm that you acknowledge the following statements. Once you have confirmed the project area description, mapping, and agreed to the disclaimer on your request, you can submit your request by clicking the Submit button. After submitting the request, a confirmation of the request will pop up on screen. This will include the request number, mapping, details, and affected utility members. You can download the confirmation sheet by clicking Actions and Download Confirmation Sheet. You will also receive an email with the request confirmation. Please note that a planning and design request number is distinctly different than an 811 ticket number. The planning and design request number will start with the state abbreviation that the request was submitted in, followed by 7 digits. Some utility members may elect to receive planning and design notifications from our center, but this is not guaranteed. You can check your confirmation sheet to see which utility members were notified about your planning and design request. Under Utility Owner Details, you will see a list of all the members who were included on your planning and design request. If a utility member was notified about your request, it should read Notification Sent in the status column. Any utility members who are not notified about your request will be highlighted red, and it will read Not Notified in the status column. Since planning and design notifications are optional at this time, you will need to contact utility operators directly using the contact information provided on your request. If you have any additional questions or concerns regarding planning and design requests, please contact our Member Services Department at memberservices@usan.org.